just how thrilled are you with the improvement in the defensive standards since the international break?
Yeah, like I said, just compliments for the lads. So it's brilliant. I think in all, we have right now in 9 games 5 clean sheets and right now 4 in a row. So our defending is brilliant right now. So it's always a basement, especially after such a difficult beginning. So to improve and so such a short term, it's really good and it's always a basement for success. And yeah, we know right now we have to do without some really important player in our offense, like Nelson Oliveira, like Alex Pritchard, so James Maddison, we had to do without him in the last 6 days. So we know, so when all the offensive guys are there, so we're perhaps a little bit stronger in this area of the pitch. But all in all, I think so our offensive was not bad too today. So we created chances and we were just didn't have the quality today to finish one of these situations. And for that, yeah, we have to live with it. So in general, when we calm down and in 1 or 2 days we will see, okay, there's a big improvement in our game and a really good basement for the next week. So with these defending, with these quality in many topics of the game, we know, just we have to work on the finishing situation. So I think it would be totally deserved win today, and yeah, it would be possible to have more points in the table. So for that, we are right now in this moment after the game really disappointed and, to be honest, a bit frustrated that we were not able to win this game. But all in all, a big improvement, and just have compliments for this improvement for the lads.
And where Frank has gone as well, I mean, he had to keep his concentration because there was one good save in there, wasn't it, when he tipped over.
That's right.
For a young man who's come in, playing his first senior football, to keep 4 clean sheets in a row must be a big deal for his sort of psychology.
Yes, that's right. Because to be fair, in the last games he didn't have so many saves and action, and you always have to be concentrated. It's a little bit like for a really big club who's on top of the table. So then the goalkeeper pretty often has 70, 80 minutes without one action, and then I think there was this deflected shoot, and he has to be there with the hands, and he was there. So I think he seemed to be really, really grown and showed a good calmness and a really good concentration. And I think it's extraordinary, especially for such a young guy. And yeah, we are really content with Angus.
How worried are you about the lack of goals, Daniel? I mean, 2 goals in 4 games. How concerned?
Not so much, because especially it was important we focused a little bit more our defense, especially after the beginning. That was one topic. The second topic was we created, I think, enough chances. And especially in the last game, cup game, away game at Brentford, it was the same level. So we created, I don't know, 10 or 11 really good chances and scored at least 3 times in this game. So I think we have the quality to create chances. Yeah, we didn't have the quality in the last 2 home games against Burton and today to score out of this situation. We know, okay, there are some players who will come back, who will help us in this quality in the finishing situation. But I'm not too concerned, because that's a topic to have this coolness and this brutality and the quality in the finishing situation. Yeah, you can't simulate so much in the training, because it's more in the head to be really cool and to be really focused when there is such a big chance in front of, I don't know, nearly 30,000 people. So you can't simulate the situation so much in the training. So I'm not too concerned about it. So we know right now it's what was left to have 3 points in this game. But yeah, it is like this. Sometimes you have to live with it. Yeah, Mario got a hit in the first half on his muscle, and he wasn't able to run after 60 minutes. Was a little bit sad, because he had a brilliant game in the cup, and he's always to create something special with a finishing pass or with a set piece, and he's able to score goals too. So was not a player we had to do without in the, especially at least in the last 30 minutes. So but I hope it's just a hit, and he will be available for the Middlesbrough game in the middle of the week, I hope. And yeah, Wes had some problems, because he fell on his knees and felt a lot of pain. But I think so. I just spoke pretty short with him, so he said, "Okay, it's better. Hopefully, it's not too bad." so he will be available for the Middlesbrough game too. But yeah, we have to wait how it develops.
Just last one from me. You went without Alex Tetti today. Was that with Middlesbrough in mind, sort of knowing that that's going to be a very difficult game?
Yes, was one reason. So on the one hand, we wanted to take a little bit more risk this home game. So we brought in Harrison Reed, who is a little bit more an offensive player in comparison to Alex Tetti, and the same with Marley Watkins, who is a little bit more a striker than Yannick Wildschaert. So we got the feeling, okay, we are in such a good shape, and we are good in defending and can bring some more offensive player on the pitch. And I think it was a right decision because we didn't have a problem in our defense. And the second topic was two pretty hard away games will happen in the next days, and we know. So for Alex, it means a lot of load. And in tactical terms, I think I need him more in the away games in Middlesbrough and Reading too. And for that, I think it was the right decision. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Thanks.